for this afternoon to our show.
This show is performed by 5th and 6th graders who give your time, talent, and energy to perform for you.
Our show is about a simple little invention.
The radio.
Although it's been around a long time,
and has brought music and information to millions of people,
its contributions are being eclipsed by email, podcasts, Facebook, Instagram, well, you get it.
But it's free,
and it's still being heard by millions of people across the globe.
So please sit back
and listen to our tribute to the radio. It's entitled On the Radio
by John Jacobson and John Higgins.
What in the world is that?
It's a radio.
A radio?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, my granny and granddad have one. What are you going to do with it?
I'm going to listen to it.
Why?
Because it's amazing.
So does it download music?
No.
Does it stream music?
No.
Does it respond to commands?
Like what commands?
Siri, play Baby Shark.
No, it doesn't do that. Francine, for heaven's sake, your dad has a radio in your car. He's always listening to KRAZ.
Hello, baby! It's the marvelous Mike at the mic. Welcome to the radio station that plays the hits while you sing along.
Jive and Juliet here. We've got the oldies, the goodies, and all the songs that people have loved throughout the years.
Fun, 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 funny.
Money, honey. from the person that I love best. I finally reached for my baby about a half past three. He said, I'd like to know what you want.
Here, we'll steer we are.
tough and we did make it through the Great Depression.
Hey, Mike, why did they call it great?
I think this is just one of those alternative adjectives. It can be wonderful or just great.
Wow, I get it now.
This is Missy Smith reporting for KRAZ.
And Candy Jones reporting with her. We have a report on our country.
Our country was very depressed.
A lot of people lived in their cars. Oh wait, we still do that.
Yes, Americans were in tough times financially, but the radio was tremendously entertaining.
Our reporters, Grace and Louise, will tell you all about the broadcast that affected our whole nation.
Radio is sometimes called the talking telegram.
And in the 1930s, millions of Americans had own radios.
It was hugely entertaining.
One series, Our Gal Sunday, was about a small town girl falling in love with a rich Englishman.
Young girls were avid listeners.
And he was like the Lone Ranger in the shadow, carried on bravely against the forces of evil. It was the idea of young actor Orson Welles that created the most excitement.
It was a radio broadcast pretending to be a legitimate newscast that warned readers that Martians had invaded Earth.
It was 1938.
It was the War of the Worlds.
Many people believed in the broadcast. It caused a sensation.
But people of that time enjoyed a little scare.
One spring song gained a following. It was called The Little Man Who Wasn't There.
Last night I saw upon the stair a little man who wasn't there. He wasn't there again today. Oh, how I wish he'd go away.
When I came home last night, three, the man was waiting there for me. But when I looked around the hall, I couldn't see him there at all.
Go away, go away, don't you come back anymore. Go away, go away, please don't stand the door. Last night I saw upon the stair a little man who wasn't there. He wasn't there again today. Oh, how I wish he'd go away.
Dear Joey, I missed you so much. Even my little brother Tommy says it's lonely here without you.
Do not.
I'll miss Tommy too. He's such a nice little guy.
He says you're a nice little guy.
I'm not little.
And he says you're nice.
I'm not little. Yes, I am.
Well, Joey, I know how brave you are.
It's true. I am very brave. It takes a lot of guts to run on you.
Saving people and saving small dogs and cats.
Yeah, that's our goal, right?
And keeping your camp clean.
I keep it very clean. Clean as whistle.
But you never talk about what else you do.
Well, actually, I'm going to do very great thing.
What is it, Dennis?
I risk my life every day.
What?
It's true. Well, they may need to come new bugle.
What? That's dangerous?
Well, yeah, they might not throw things at me if I hit the wrong note.
Oh, Joey, I'm so proud. I think you're
smart as a jellyfish.
Smart as a jellyfish. Oh my gosh, I'm not going to write that.
Gloria. So, dearest, I must go. There's a new song coming, and I have to play my trump.
Oh.
Better than that.
You just can't compete with Alice. Elvis.
No way you can compete with Elvis.
Did you know sometimes Elvis gives away whole cars?
I don't see what good it'll do to give away half a car.
Good one, Johnny.
Thanks, it's all up here.
Very impressive.
I heard that Elvis might be coming into our town.
Where did you hear that? It was on the radio.
I love the radio, it is such good news. I heard that he might be performing at Elvis in the concert hall.
Me too, I've been practicing some of my own Elvis moves that will drive the girls wild.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Like this one?
That's amazing.
Amazingly wrong.
But Mom!
And he would also like if you turn
turned on the radio.
But it's the Beatles, and they're huge. I don't know like a band just like theirs with all the hardback bugs.
You can't practice in the garage anymore.
Yeah, we can't hear the Beatles on our radio.
I'll play anywhere I want.
But Ronnie,
I don't think that'll work.
What won't work?
Hardback bugs for the name of the band.
Oh.
Yeah, that's just another name for the Beatles.
Helen, please go back to your room. I need time alone.
Just because you're born first doesn't mean you're the boss. We're twins and we'll always be twins.
I'm oldest, therefore I'm the boss.
I'm smarter, therefore I'm the boss.
I love the Beatles more than you.
No!
Paul McCartney is my new crush.
I'm so excited. The Beatles are singing in New York.
And we'll be able to hear it on the radio.
I hope we get our radio fixed. If not, can we come over to your house, Emily?
Of course, dear. I've already reserved a program on our family schedule.
You have a schedule?
Of course. Doesn't everyone?
Nobody in my house.
Yeah, even if Mom made a schedule, my brother would change it so we could listen to his favorite talk show. He wants to hear people talk and he can hear the Beatles sing.
What's your brother's favorite talk show?
It's about how to fix things, and so far he's broken apart two clocks and a brave little toaster. But he hasn't been able to put anything back together.
You know, it would be really cool if we had tiny boxes with pictures in them.
Called radio vision?
I think those are here.
And then show ordinary people fixing things, so anyone can do it.
I think it would be hard to learn how to put something together without seeing how it's done.
Hey, I know. We could go listen to the Beatles downtown. I hear they're broadcasting the whole concert in Wanda Park.
Yeah, we could go get ice cream and go listen to the park while we eat ice cream.
I hope they play Hard Day's Night.
Yeah, they could call it Boo Boo too, because it's helping people fix mechanical boo boos.
I hope it's come together.
I'll just die if it's please, please me.
Well, I would die.
The time
British invasion.
They were called the Beach Boys, and they represented the best of the West in our love affair with California and the surf.
I love the Beatles, but I want to be a surfer girl.
Bobby, the Beach Boys just don't measure up to the Beatles.
Have you heard the song Surf City? That song's amazing.
What about I Saw Her Standing There? It makes me just want to stand there. Somebody was in me standing there. It made a song about me.
That seems kind of hopeless.
Look at me.
See, I'll be noticed.
By some random psychiatrist looking for patients.
That's me.
I'm sorry, but it's hard to imagine anybody who likes the Beatles more than the Beach Boys.
Not funny, you're just jealous.
Bobby, you just...
everywhere.
I was in the National Public Radio, which is an independent radio station supported by donations.
What does that mean?
It's so hurting.
You know, given a special quote on flip-flops, because flip-flops by advertisement.
It's important to all of us to have lots of choices when it comes to our information.
Besides, I don't wear flip-flops anymore since a horse stepped on my toe.
And we're glad we know that.
And we're glad we have the radio.
And we love our jobs at KRAZ.
But there is one thing we know.
Without the radio, we wouldn't be dancing. Dispenser.
And that's it from KRAZ.